See, that's where it gets a little bit complicated here, because I keep hearing three different entities, and we're only charging you this much. It's only a few pennies, but yet we have not given the ratepayer a clear message. How much exactly is coming out of my pocket? And we have not given that clear message as much as I think we've tried. So this is complicated. This is another thing about, this increase. Because if we say yes to this increase today, we already said yes to the Solid Waste Authority. Is that correct?
Yes, that's correct.
Yeah. So there's more money added on to this. And then after this, is there another rate increase that's coming
in? No. We'll be coming back to you in January to talk about where we're going with the whole thing. I actually believe that there's some things we can do that could result in a decrease in rates.
Well, Mr. Peterson,
it's really hard to say that.
And you know what? And I've seen you work, and you've done good work. But that's where my concern goes. Where sometimes we're making decisions, but we backtrack and they say, "But we're going to come back and see how we can save them some money."
If I could. One of the reasons why it's so complicated is that this fee increase cannot happen. The Republic fee increase cannot happen until the solid waste fee happens, because they can't set their fee until the Solid Waste Authority, which transfers all the trash out of the city that Republic collects in the city. So until that fee is set, then Republic sets their fees. So this is the final fees. This is where they come into it, but it can't be known when Solid Waste is setting their fees. They do not know what Republic is going to do, and Republic does not know what the fee is going to be until the Solid Waste Authority sets theirs. I agree. One of the reasons I believe we need to look at this, we need to understand how we communicate it, we need to understand how we calculate it, we need to understand how this works so that we can create better relationships through communication. It's not there, but at the same time, we're at a place in the calendar where those fees, we're contractually obligated to this fee for Republic under the franchise agreement. And the Solid Waste Authority had their own needs. But that doesn't mean we can't come back in 6 months and look at how to improve this and create a system that works better for all of us.
Mr. Peterson, good point there. But once you increase the rate, can you decrease it later on?
We'll find out.
See you. Thank you.
Jill.
So, Gary, following on Tony's question, I just want you to expand a little bit on, because I think it's really important for us to understand that the very modest minimal increase that happened at Solid Waste last month is for the bond in order for the money to move the transfer station. I mean, that's so critical.
Yes.
To our plans, to the neighborhood, to SUBA. And I want you to just more fully address that, because I think that's really important. And then also, I want to say this with you and Doug here, is that you really helped us go through that with Solid Waste, because we were looking at a very substantial increase. And working with you too and helping us to make a more modest increase and then be able to adjust and deal with all this later. So I just, could you expand on that? Because it's so important.
Sure. One of the things that we looked at with the Solid Waste Authority, for the first time has bonds that they can refinance. The time is right. They've come there. But they need to retain a certain level of funding in order to do that. So by getting this nominal fee, this allowed them to keep their bond indebtedness at a certain level so they could refinance it, which would then free up money to begin to facilitate the move of Sun Street. And although everyone would like that to happen immediately, we still need to do environmental work and get it moving. But we're committed to doing that, and we worked with the Solid Waste Authority to get that. Because that is key to this. I don't think that there's anyone that believes that is located in the right place. We need to get it out of downtown. And this is right now the best way we have to do that. So the small increment, which realizes that then becomes, it was a $3 a ton tipping fee and a $3 ton transportation fee, which is in the 70 cents, was set by the Solid Waste Authority. That allows them to retain their bond integrity so that they can refinance, generate the several million dollars it's going to take in order to facilitate the move. So that's one part of it. The second part of it, what was the second question there? I'm sorry.
Well, it wasn't a question as much as just kudos to you two for walking, helping us through this.
I'm sorry. The other piece of it was that the Solid Waste Authority, in looking at how they set their fees, wanted to move from a tipping charge to an overall service charge. And with all due respect to Republic, and in fairness to Republic, this was a new way of calculating fees that they weren't sure quite how to react to. So they covered all their bases. This is my interpretation, that they covered all their bases, which resulted in a potential very large increase to upwards of 25% to the city. So we worked with the Solid Waste Authority to put off the shift in the way they increase their fees. In other words, recycling has gone so well. The trash business is down. In fact, you learn that the people in solid waste business can tell you more about your economy than anyone else by the amount of waste that moves in and out based on what people buy and what they don't buy. A very strong economic indicator. But as trash goes down, they still have costs for processing, for operating the plant. So as they taught me to learn at the Solid Waste Authority, when you get down to that, you've recycled everything, you've reused everything, and you get down to that final ton of garbage, it's going to be a $7 million ton because you still have to cover costs, you still have to cover bond indebtedness. So their idea was that they would distribute this fee across to all users evenly, instead of using a tipping fee. That may well have some merit, but it's something we need to look at in the next 6 months, need to work through that with Republic so we can all understand how that works. So this was moving pretty fast. Republic reacted, and we were in a tough jam. We worked with Solid Waste to keep it down. We've worked with Republic. We're working on these relationships to make it work, and we want to go forward in the next 6 months and sort out a whole host of issues that'll make us more effective at what we're doing.
And then just to follow up, and Gary, it might be you answering this one, or Jose might answer this one better. And that was in terms of our bond integrity, it couldn't come from reserves or anything else. It had to come from, and could you explain that, rate increases? And this was required by the bondholders. So go ahead.
Mayor, members of council, Jose Gamboa from Southern Nevada Solid Waste Authority. Yes, our bond obligation requires that our revenues need to come in from tipping fees. So that is the one of the requirements so that once you approve the resolution, then we can proceed with refinancing our bond. And right now we have a great opportunity because the interest rates are low and we can save about $260,000 a year. Regarding Tony's councilmember Barrera question regarding the future of our rates, is that we have two exciting projects, conversion technology projects at the authority. One is an autoclave that we hope to locate at our transfer station on Work Street. We are working with URS to develop the scope of work for CEQA that has been finalized. But this project will change our operations, and it has the strong potential of reducing our transportation cost from Salinas to Johnson Canyon, in addition to reducing also the cost of processing, because the company that we have signed an agreement, it has come in with a proposal of about $39 a ton. And then we have the second project at Johnson Canyon, which is to bring in a unit that will produce electricity. So those two jobs are going to change our operations. So we have to be looking at a new operational model and how that is going to affect costs. But the exciting thing about this project is that it brings economic development. And we have an incredible opportunity to transform what we call waste into a material resource or into energy. We have that opportunity here in the Salinas Valley, and that's something that I believe we should be extremely proud of. In addition, we had an economic study done in a projected 1,700 jobs. That's why approving the rate is also an investment to continue moving forward into those projects and what it can bring to the valley.
Okay, thank you. Okay, Steve.
And if I might just comment, I am often struck by the visionary approach that the Solid Waste Authority takes to solid waste without landfills. But I'm a very pragmatic person, and I really appreciate their vision. But we got to move that. We got to move that transfer station, and our citizens care about what their bills are going to cost next month. And though I do appreciate the long-term vision and what's out there for us, as a city, we have those two responsibilities, and that's where we are standing with our partners in solid waste, and that's where we need to stand.
Okay, thank you, Steve.
Yeah, it's a question, but it might veer on comments, so maybe I'll wait.
Okay.
Okay. Just, I hope I can ask a question if it comes up with the comment later. Is that?
I'll pretend not to notice it's a question in the
okay.
comment period.
Okay.
Sergio?
Gary, why are we not, if we're a big city the size of Salinas, why don't we have better rates? And why are we having to unload the garbage here in Salinas and then load it up and then transport it to Johnson? Why can't we negotiate with Marina? And maybe it's a complicated question, but why are we not having better rates negotiated? Why are we not just taking it directly from the homes directly to Marina? Because I think a lot of the justification is tipping fees and transportation, and I think those could be avoided if we could use our volume to negotiate better rates and to take it closer by, even saving, you know, our footprint in this community by not having so many trucks back and forth.
Yes, well, first of all, I would say that we actually, compared to neighboring communities, have a pretty good trash rate. I mean, our rate for fees is competitive with other communities. So I think that's important to understand. Okay, but in terms of, you know, it's a very interesting conversation. Yes, it's complicated. I'm not sure why we have two authorities myself, and I'm trying to figure that out. I know that they do different things, and that the Solid Waste Authority was formed largely because we got out of the landfill business with Crazy Horse. Mm. No?
No.
Okay, well,
let's stay focused on the issue.
That's the history I had. But we partnered with the county to get out of the landfill business. The Solid Waste Authority was primarily formed to manage landfills and then find locations to relocate the solid waste that was going to Crazy Horse and other locations. At the same time, Marina was doing what they did for the peninsula. So we ended up with the Salinas Valley Authority and then the Peninsula Authority. I think that there's a very important conversation to be had looking at possibilities. I do not know, because of the finances or the organizational structures, what an outcome could be, but I believe there's a very important conversation in there, because it feels as though there's duplicative services.
Okay, and just from Republic Services, is this really necessary, and if it is, How do you justify it? I mean, we just went through an increase in how does it justify doing it? We put people through an increase not too long ago that produced some very good services with the graffiti, that's some pretty good services you're providing. You see the new trucks, but how is it justified? And if it's really necessary, and if it is, how is it justified? And I'd like to hear that from Republic Services. Maybe you're not part of the show, but I just wanted to hear from you.
Not so much a justification as a contractual requirement. When we renegotiated the contract back in 2010, there were certain provisions put in there where we could get a CPI adjustment, and really we only get 75% of the CPI. I mean, the city goes out and they get full CPI adjustment on their rates. We only get 75% of it. So part of what I have to do is operate as efficiently as I can to make up for that difference. The fuel recovery is in there now because we're still burning diesel. It is coming down, and as we add more of our natural gas trucks, that'll go away. So that savings there will be passed on into the community. But, you know, the basic premise here is that, you know, there's a big hit on the disposal side of the element. There's three components to the rates, and that's our service fee, the disposal component, and the city's franchise fee. And they're all interrelated. And I think Gary's, we've all been through a tiresome time. He's been very patient to learn and work. It's been thrown on him real quick. But I think we've tried to work together to come up with what we think is going to be a short-term solution that meets the requirements of the contract, and then look at a long-term issuance, looking at the dynamics of all of this, because there is going to be some things that have to be adjusted on all of those sides to make it work for the community as a whole. Right now, it's not there. If we were going to make that drastic change that was what was going to be proposed, it was going to create a lot of havoc. So we went back to the drawing board. We tried to work together to see what we could do. And I think we came up with the best workable plan that we could put in right now. Is it perfect? No. Is what's going to come down in the future going to be better? We don't know. But we're at least going to work on it and see what fits.
Just lastly, in your opinion, do you think we could be negotiating better rates for... You know, I like to see us paying what San Martin and Morgan Hill and Gilroy and some of those other folks pay for bringing their garbage here, even though they call it it's using airspace. But can we negotiate better rates because of our volume compared to the smaller cities that don't have the volume? And are we subsidizing some of that? And the other one, would it be easier for you to not have to dump garbage here and then have it transported back to all the way to Gonzales, but rather to Marina? That's just your personal opinion or professional opinion.
Well, all I've ever asked for in the last 11 years, you probably, those of you that sat on the Waste Authority Board have been tired of hearing me, is that we desperately need, you know, a 900-ton-a-day transfer station in the city so I don't have to drive out of the city limits to haul trash. I shouldn't be the transporter. I'm your collector. And I am efficient and operating well when I'm collecting, not when I'm deadheading back and forth down the freeway or to other landfills or other places. So critical in our assessment when we originally came here and set the rates was that we would always have the ability to tip within the city limits. When we have to drive outside of the city limits, it increases our operating costs, and we have to build that into the service fee to recover it. The most efficient way is for us to stay right on the streets, pick it up, get it to a really good functioning transfer station, and then they can long haul that volume where a tractor trailer can take three of my truck loads somewhere else versus me driving three trucks back and forth and absorbing all the cost and the energy for that. So we've been looking for nothing more and asking for nothing more from the Waste Authority, which and the city, is that we really need that fully functioning transfer station. That's what's critical to us in the city of Salinas. The rates you can address. I'm your collector. I'm your garbage man. I'm not on the disposal end of the business. So I really don't have a dog in that fight unless, you know, it happens to affect the way my operation and the efficiency and the cost of running it. But I think you as the city and the people on the city council have that ability. I don't.
All right, we will go to public comment, 2 minutes.
Good evening, everybody. I'm Gary Alameda. I'd like to ask you all a question, and it is, did you get a notice about this put in your garbage bill? Did anybody here get a warning or a notice?
Gary, public comment, please.
That there was going to be an increase? No, you did not. I have asked here at the council, I have asked at the solid authority meetings, if the public can be properly notified, and they were not. And it irks me that I have a council here who is for the people, but yet We did not get a notice. You didn't even get a notice. And it's just, we're supporting a sinking ship. The authority soon will be in a total debt of $60 million. And then they want to move at a projected cost of another $10 or $12 million. A citizen in this city can jump in his truck, take his trash 10 miles, and save $20 a ton on his trash. It just doesn't make sense.
Okay, thank you, Gary.
Next.
Good evening, Mr. Mayor and council members. I'm Bob Perkins, and I'm here now as just a resident of Salinas. And let me preface my remarks by saying in my neighborhood, Republic does a fine job of picking up the trash. I'm very happy with the service. However, as you know, your franchise fee includes a component of 26% off the top. That's skimmed off the top of Republic's income, gross income. And it, to me, it still has all of the components of a tax, and I still believe it is a tax that was improperly imposed. And of course, now when you take this action today and you raise their fee according to your contract, you're also voting to raise your income, your taxes from this. And I think this is an improper action, and I object to it. And let me also note that your contract to do this, to give the CPI increase, is essentially a contract that mandates a legislative action. What is your choice? Your contract says you will vote every year and you will give them a CPI adjustment according to figures. You don't have any choice. I think that's a questionable situation too. You should remember that your constituents are paying 26% more than they should pay for Republic's trash service because of this tax component. And I think the public needs to be aware of that. And I think there also needs to be some explanation on the Republic bills. Unlike many other utilities, the bills don't explain what the users are paying for. And I resent that. I think this whole thing is improper, and eventually something's going to be done about it. And I look forward to the return of my money that I've paid in on this improper tax when that day comes when somebody remedies the situation. But you need to be aware of it, and the public needs to be aware. Sorry to tell you that, but thank you.
Okay, next.
Good afternoon again, or good evening. Margaret Cernabinetti, and I'm going to ditto a lot of really, so I'm not going to repeat it all on my agreement regarding the tax, the fee increases. It does make more sense for this garbage to be going at, for us to be getting a lower rate for the amount of population that we have actually have. So I'm going to agree with what Mr. Sanchez said regarding that. And we should be going to Marina, but I'm also going to mention it because the comments that were made by Mr. Gamboa regarding renewable energy at the landfill on Johnson Canyon with the Solid Waste Authority. One of the plans that was mentioned, he mentioned, what he's talking about is Plasco, and Plasco has been here, and they've given you their really nice PowerPoint presentation. But the truth is they have not been designated as being renewable energy. They do not qualify for renewable energy points. Right now, they're at a complete standstill, cannot even go forward because California has not said that they're renewable energy, and they're scrambling. Well, they spent quite a lot of time with lobbyists scrambling in Sacramento trying to get something through the current legislation, and they didn't do it. And so right now they're in secret process with a company that is not even qualified for renewable energy. So I really don't even know where Mr. Gamboa comes off saying that this is renewable energy, that they're gonna take garbage, turn it into electricity. They've had this project in Canada, and they haven't been doing it in Canada. And I know that we all wish sometimes, you know, we wish for these fantastic things. My kids, when they were growing up, they wanted those lasers from Star Wars, and they look great in the movies, but they don't exist. So Plasco's renewable energy is myth right now. So you can can that project, and the authority is in a huge deficit. And so it's like throwing more taxpayer good money into
a black hole. And I ask for you to please, you need to inform the public, send the information out and the bills.
Okay,
thank you.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, Mr. Mayor, council members, city manager. My name is Jose Martinez Aldaña, and I'm here representing myself today. I have had many conversations with the organization that I do represent, SUBA, and I do have their blessing actually to go ahead and speak out. I'm not actually going to speak out against the increase that Republic is presenting today, because I think when I look at the level of increase and the amount of work that must have gone into reducing it to that amount, it's an increase, and no one likes an increase. But I appreciate the fact that there was a lot of scrutiny and belt tightening that happened so that it was minimized as much as possible. I think all of us can appreciate when we see efficiencies and the work that goes into doing that. I do have a couple of questions and then one invitation. The questions are, you know, again, we hear about these potential and hopefully they actually do materialize as very good, safe, green alternatives. The question, though, is that's being built on taxpayer dollars. My question is, what's the benefit that taxpayers are going to get when those things get built? Are the rates going to come back down, or are we going to become bondholders, or rather part owners, shareholders of those entities? Because they're being built with taxpayer dollars from residents of this community. The other invitation, again, that I wanted to go ahead and extend is, again, the SUBA board, we have met with Mr. Corpus, and they have asked me to invite so that we can actually have a conversation with all of the players at the table. City representatives, so again, the invitation is to all of you as elected officials. We will be inviting the Board of Supervisors. We've already communicated briefly with Solid Waste Authority Board and also Republic.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Anyone else?
Hello to the chair. Thank you very much for the opportunity. I'm kind of concerned because you already voted on this, the three of you on this board already voted some increases for Salinas Valley. So I'm kind of concerned it's not a double dipping over here. And I don't really like the way Jude, Mr. Donahue, put pressure on the rest of the guys. I know you can control those boards. I don't feel okay with that situation, but probably that's the way it is. One of the questions I have is, you need this increase to renegotiate this bond, and you are in the hole in $60 million, and you are selling now, you're moving this transfer station for Sun Street. So the question is, if you renegotiate this bond, you're gonna generate plenty of money to have a new transfer station in the next 2 years when you are gonna end your lease contract with Granite on Work Street? How is gonna buy the property on Sun Street? How much is gonna cost? Do you really have the money to move the transfer station now without get another bond? And we're talking about only 6 months. You're telling us you're gonna increase again on the first or the second month of the next year? Is gonna be another public meeting? Is gonna be a new public hearing? How much is gonna be the total? We would like to see the numbers. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you. Anyone else from the public?